I'm pleased to be here today at St. Clair County's Mass Vaccination Center. And thanks go out today to many, many individuals who made this operation possible, including and really the dedicated workforce of the St. Clair County Health Department. Both health departments in the county have been great during COVID-19 in this pandemic, working hard. Also the Illinois National Guard, who is here today and who staffs a huge part of this operation. They're our partners, as well as FEMA, who has a team here today making sure that people are contacted and are able to get here. So. And then that also includes, and they're members of what we like to call Team St. Clair. And Team St. Clair knows who they are. They're part of these operations and have been for a long time now. Special thanks goes out to Myla Blandford, who's our COVID czar in the county, and Herb Simmons, who is our EMA director and my right arm, and our state senators and our state representatives. They've all been great during this time. They're behind me. You're going to hear from them today. Anytime we had an issue, they were there, and certainly they've been a part of our effort. So together, we've faced waves, we've faced shortages, we've faced spikes, and a myriad of other bumps along the road to eradicate COVID-19. But for our whole journey, our governor has been by our side. And when I say the whole journey, the governor was here 341 days ago at a press conference at the St. Clair County Health Department when all of this started to come about. And at that point in time, he committed resources and committed the time and the talent of all of his employees in the state to be able to solve this issue. And he's been with us all along the way. We couldn't have asked for more from the state. They've helped us in immeasurable ways, and today I think is one of the stops along the way to get COVID-19 out of our community. It gives me great pleasure to welcome and introduce the governor of the great state of Illinois, and a governor who cares about the people of St. Clair County and Illinois, Governor J.B. Pritzker.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you.
Governor, could you take your mask off just so you sound distinct?
I will. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you so much to Chairman Kern for your leadership of the county here. And it is great to be back in St. Clair County. I always look forward to coming here. There are a lot of terrific leaders here in this county, and they are showing their leadership every day as we are making our way through this difficult time. I want to thank Leader Jay Hoffman, to Senator Chris Belt and Representative Latoya Greenwood for joining me here today on this tour of the amazing vaccination operations here at the fairgrounds, and to St. Clair County Health Department Deputy Director Myla Blandford and St. Clair County Emergency Management Agency Director Herb Simmons. I really am grateful for your partnership, for your work with the National Guard, working with the Illinois Department of Public Health in the essential work of fighting this pandemic. The St. Clair Bell Fairgrounds, which has administered over 10,000 doses since opening on February 1st, is one of the most vital mass vax sites in this state. And it is a vital partnership with the Illinois National Guard, which has assisted local public health departments all across the state. This is not the only mass vac site, although for everybody here it may feel like it. Across the state, we've deployed hundreds of National Guardsmen and women to create mass vaccination sites, for example, at the Tinley Park Convention Center in Cook County, the Illinois State Fairgrounds in Springfield, and two more sites launching tomorrow in Carbondale at the Carbondale Civic Center and Banterra Center at SIU's Carbondale campus. And there are more, and even more beyond that, yet to come. We anticipate that we will have 100 teams of about 18 National Guards men and women that will be deployed all across the state once we have all of our vaccination sites set up. And again, they operate as support for those who are on the front lines of this battle, and that is our local public health departments. Our Illinois National Guard is the driving force behind our mobile vaccination support teams Dozens of those teams are working even now. Again, we'll have dozens more working over the next couple of weeks. Four teams are here, right here at the fairgrounds. And another two are working with the Eastside Health Department in East St. Louis. These are true collaborations with the goal of increasing accessibility. Here at the fairgrounds, for example, the health department has teamed up with the county transportation authorities to provide free transit to get those in need to their appointments. We now have more than 850 vaccination locations available across the state, with nearly 2 million total doses administered to date. And next week, thanks to the Biden administration's new increases in vaccine supply and the new federal direct-to-pharmacy partnership, we're expecting another 500,000 doses to come to Illinois. We have built processes and infrastructure to keep going and growing as supply increases. And it's because of that capacity that in the month of February, we're administering among the highest number of doses per capita among the 10 most populous states in this nation. And despite having the sixth highest population, we've administered the fifth most doses overall among the states. With more than 12.5 million residents, Illinois still has a long way to go to get everyone vaccinated, but more than 12% of our population has already received at least their first dose. Overall, our progress to date is something everyone in Illinois should be proud of. That doesn't mean getting an appointment for a vaccine hasn't been a frustrating experience. It doesn't mean that it isn't frustrating for me as governor to not have enough supply coming into the state to provide for everyone who wants to be vaccinated. Indeed, with a national shortage of vaccine to begin with, we've all had to be patient to wait our turn. But we will get through this. And with a new president and a new administration in charge of vaccine distribution, we've already seen the first signs of big change. In recent weeks, we've seen increasing vaccine supply, nearly 30% more on a weekly basis to states since President Biden took over. And I have great hope that the new Johnson & Johnson vaccine will be approved following the FDA's February 26th meeting, adding significant new vaccine supplies over the coming weeks and months. Things are getting better. We will get through this, but in the meantime, please, everyone, mask up. Keep helping each other out, and we will get through this together. So thank you, and with that, I'd like to turn it over to really one of the esteemed members of the Senate here in Illinois, someone who in his first term has really made a mark, is a leader, sponsored major legislation, some of which I intend to sign soon, Senator. And I really want to just express my appreciation for all that he does for the people of this region, Senator Chris Belt.
To the let me do this. All right. To the governor, thank you for your steadfast and unwavering leadership throughout this pandemic. You have always, as Chairman Kearns stated earlier, you have always been there. And it's not easy to govern during prosperity, let alone a once-in-a-lifetime pandemic. But in addition, I would like to thank you for putting conscience over political expedience, putting people first in your actions, not playing politics, but just having, letting the science and having regards for the general welfare of the public. I thank you. To Team St. Clair and Chairman Mark Kearns, thank you for what you've done. I mean, this site is amazing. To really, as we toured around, to really get the gravity of what they do here and understand that, you know, from 8 in the morning to 8 p.m., they have the capacity to give the shot to between 1,200 to 2,000 people. That's amazing. when you think of the efficiency and the effectiveness of the number of shots that they give out, that's really putting a dent in this war against the pandemic. Finally, to the public, we are all excited because we are now receiving the shots, and rightly so. But I want to convey a message to you. As a kid, as kids, when we would go on family vacations, we would all jump in the back and our parents would take off and we would be in the back of the car, and inevitably we would ask our mom, how far do we have to go? And she would let us do that back and forth for maybe an hour or two, and then she would turn around and she would say, we are closer to our destination than when we left, but we still have a long way to go. That's the message I want to give to our public. And we are closer to the end than we ever were, but we still have a long way to go. Please be vigilant. Please continue to adhere to the guidelines of the CDC and IDPH, and I promise you, we will get there. That being said, I would want to bring up my friend and my General Assembly colleague. They don't always go together, but he is truly a friend of mine and a leader, Jay Hoffman. Thank you.
Well, thank you, friend. Governor, thank you so very much. This is just amazing, and what Team Sinclair has done and Mark Kern, and I would just like to make sure that we all here express our extreme thanks to the National Guard, because without them, we wouldn't be here. The vaccinating up to, could eventually, when supply comes from the federal government, over 2,000 individuals a day. Right now, as they'll indicate, we're doing around 1,000 a day. My office is just up the road, and I come by here and I'm amazed at the number of cars going in and out, getting their vaccinations. Now, let me just say a couple things. This has not been easy. It's been difficult on the population of St. Clair County, population of the entire state, men and women of the entire state. It's been hard on businesses. It's been hard on folks who are on the front line. But there is light at the end of the tunnel, and we are getting close to our destination. So let's keep vigilant. Let's keep fighting. And as we get more vaccines from the federal government, I want to thank the governor, because now we are set up, and it's beginning to be set up across the entire state, that as the vaccines come, people are going to get them in their arm, and they're going to be vaccinated from this terrible, terrible, terrible disease. And we, in the very near future, will be as much back to normal as we could hope for or could have ever foreseen way back 341 days ago. So with that, I would like to thank again the governor. And I would like to introduce my colleague, a great friend from East St. Louis, who does a great job of representing that area, Representative Latoya Greenwood.
Thank you, Leader Hoffman. Thank you, Governor, and thank you, Chairman Kern. Last week, I had the pleasure of accompanying my parents here to this facility to receive their vaccinations. And I want to thank the people and the staff here that for their kindness and their patience and their professionalism through that process. I want to reassure those who have had difficulty with access to computers and other forms of technology that we will continue to improve the process of how to register to receive the vaccination and to eliminate the barriers to ensure that everyone who wants to receive the vaccination will have the opportunity to receive the vaccination in the near future. And I look forward to working with the county and the Eastside Health District in making sure that everyone can receive the vaccination in the 114th district moving forward. Thank you, and I would like to bring up Myla Blanford.
Good afternoon. I'm Myla Blanford, Deputy Director of St. Clair County Health Department and Operations for COVID Response. On behalf of our Executive Director, Barb Holt, and the team we have back at the Health Department, I welcome all of you to the St. Clair County Mass Vaccination Site. I'd like to thank Governor Pritzker, the Illinois Department of Public Health, Illinois National Guard, FEMA, IEMA, County Board Chairman Mark Kern, St. Clair County EMA Director Herb Simmons, Senator Christopher Belt, State Representatives Jay Hoffman and Latoya Greenwood for all of their help, not only today, but since the inception of this pandemic. The St. Clair County Health Department, along with Eastside Health District, the three hospitals in our area, St. Elizabeth's, Memorial, Touche, and Southern Illinois Healthcare Foundation, have combined to form the Health and Medical Alliance for St. Clair County, and this is the body that has guided vaccination distribution in our jurisdiction. It is through this collaborative effort that we were able to stand up this mass vaccination site on February the 1st. In St. Clair County, we are currently providing vaccine to 1A first-line healthcare responders, 65-plus populations, as well as 1B essential workers. Vaccinations are administered Thursday through Tuesday from 8 to 8, or as long as vaccine allows, and it's by appointment only. If individuals would like to sign up to receive appointment information, they can do so on the St. Clair County Vaccine Alert Notification Form that can be accessed on our website as well as our Facebook page, as well as St. Clair County EMA's Facebook and website as well. That form will ask about people's individual health information, their date of birth, and their occupation, and this helps us align them with the state mass vaccination tiers so we can identify uptake in certain populations, as well as provides us information as vaccine appointments become available within the county. We can then send that information out. And it's not only the health department that's providing vaccine, our partner hospitals are also providing vaccination clinics as well. For individuals who are not able to access the form online, we do have a call center set up Monday through Friday from 9 to 3. We hope to be expanding those hours in the near future. And that number is 618-825-4447. Again, 618-825-4447. And Spanish English translators are available at that line. This mass vaccination site offers two different options for people to receive vaccine. One is the drive-through that you saw when all of you came in. We have gotten really good response from the community. People like to be able to stay in their vehicles and not navigate the cold weather. The second option, where all of you are at now, is the internal operation, and this is accessed via mass transit. We have a local Shield Street station that has light rail and bus traffic as well as bike traffic. There's a dedicated service line at that location where individuals can be dropped at the front door here, receive their vaccine, and then be bused back to that location. In addition, individuals who qualify for ATS service can be brought here as long as you meet the guidelines for the transit district. There's been some question about second dose appointments. When people are eligible for their second dose appointment, they should receive their second dose from the same entity in which they received their first dose, if at all possible, and that's who you would schedule that second dose with. For the health department, as it becomes time for your second dose, we'll send out notification via email or text indicating it's a scheduling appointment for your second dose. If you have questions, you can contact that entity where you received your first one. Our goal here is to be able to vaccinate as many people who are willing in the shortest amount of time possible. With that being said, we still want to encourage community testing. We want individuals to go to our test sites. We have St. Clair Square still operating Monday through Sunday, 8 to 4, as well as MedExpress and Walgreens. Now is the time to still wash your hands, socially distance, and mask. Implementation of sites like these and others is the beginning to the end of COVID. And with that, I will turn it over to Governor Pritzker for any closing questions.
Well, Governor, I have a question echoing what you were talking about the other day. When are we going to get back to normal?
Back to normal. I wish I could tell you a date. What I can tell you is that I think Senator Belt said it best. Every day we're getting closer to that. Every time we get a shipment of vaccine and people sign up and come get vaccinated, we get a little bit closer. I listen to the experts like you are, no doubt, hearing that, you know, as vaccines increase, as we have the ability to put vaccines into people's arms, that each month that goes by, the supply increases, and we are fulfilling on the major demand that exists now, that we'll get to a point where there will be a vaccine available for anybody at any time that they ask for it. Ultimately, let me just say this, we want you to be able to go to your doctor, to your own physician, or to wherever it is that you get your health care, and be able to just walk in and say, I'd like to be vaccinated. But that is a long way off at this point because we're still waiting for the manufacturers of the vaccines to get us enough supply.
Is there anything you could say to encourage small businesses that the end might be made? They are really taking travel agencies, just they had 90% drop at Belleville and customers last year, restaurants are suffering. What do you say to the small business man once this is over?
Yeah, this entire pandemic has been devastating for so many people, for individuals, for families, for small businesses. And we're working very hard, we have been for a year now, to try to prop up, bolster, help small businesses. It's challenging when you've got a deadly virus, an invisible virus that's transmitting all across the state, all across the country. But as you've seen in Illinois, actually, the people of Illinois deserve great credit. We now have one of the lowest transmission rates in the entire nation. It's one of the reasons why everybody in the state has moved back from Tier 3 mitigations, which are the highest level of mitigations that we had to impose. You remember how awful it was in November and December and January with the number of cases. Well, now we're all back in Phase 4, which is just before the end. And that means what holds us up is getting everybody vaccinated. So please, when it's your turn, when you can make an appointment, please get vaccinated. We need everybody to step up and do so. It's safe. And I think that everybody that's behind me here can tell you they know somebody, they brought their parents, people who've had it done. I mean, it might make you a little bit sore in the arm for a day. But after that, I mean, imagine being past this pandemic. Imagine the time when we're gonna all be able to go to restaurants and bars and small businesses anytime we want to, and know that we're past this terrible time.
Governor, the success of facilities like this one around the state are dependent on vaccine rollout. What are your impressions about that? There seems to be a disparity between counties for apparently no reason.
Well, I'm sorry, you're asking me about the disparity between each county's ability to administer vaccines
or to obtain vaccines?
To obtain. Oh, well, I mean, first of all, every county we look at by population and the requests that are made to the Department of Public Health, the Illinois Department of Public Health, about how many vaccination doses they would like in their county that week or month. And we have to decide, some counties ask for way more than is appropriate given the size of their county. Some counties are right on the nose. We have to make some judgment calls along the way, but what's most important is the county's ability to put together a site like this and then move people through it with some ease. And you can see, anybody that drove up here today, you can see the line of cars, the speed at which they're moving through. Remember, you've got to go through a process here. Not only do you have to line up and get up to a point where you can get vaccinated, but you also have to wait the 15 or 30 minutes after you've been vaccinated. So it's a difficult process, but one that St. Clair is doing really terrifically well.
Yeah. You know, it's obviously really difficult to get vaccines from the federal government, and you say it's getting easier, and the Biden administration has made all kinds of promises. Do you find, I have two questions. First of all, do you find that it's still a daily battle for Illinois to get doses of the vaccine? You still have to really advocate kind of a free-for-all to get those doses. And then B, you know, it wasn't the smoothest in Illinois, and we saw that with the New York Times data in the beginning. What responsibility rests on your shoulders for the mistakes in the beginning, and what will you do moving forward to make sure that you improve on whatever was wrong?
Well, let me start with the fact that I fight every day to get more vaccines to the state of Illinois. When I say fight, I mean we're on the phone, our IDPH, our governor's office, and me personally, to make sure that we're getting not only our fair share, but also to make sure that we're getting it in a speedy fashion. Now, the federal government, obviously, with the latest couple of days of terrible weather across the nation, they've had a difficult time actually distributing the vaccine to the states. So we're now starting to see those deliveries come through, but it's no fault of theirs. And I will say that the new administration has been so much better than the old administration. And so to the extent that you've seen improvements all across the nation, I would credit that with the attitude and the work of the new administration. Now, as to the state of Illinois, what was very important to us was to make sure that in phase 1A, which remember was healthcare workers and our long-term care facilities, that we were vaccinating as many of those people as possible before we started opening it up to the next phase, 1B. And so we actually stayed in 1A about a week longer than many other states because we wanted to be sure that our healthcare workers particularly got their chance. And I will say we don't control the long-term care facility administration. As you know, there's a federal pharmacy partnership program that was set up. They're responsible for getting to all those. We thought, you know, the private sector and Walgreens and CVS would be faster at that. And I think we, at one point, fairly early on, we realized we really needed to be on top of that every single day. And to their great credit, they have sped up significantly and done really a very good job since we've gotten that good working relationship going. So I feel very good about what's happened with our long-term care facilities, as well as, frankly, getting through 1A as best we could, opening it up to 1B. And then remember, Illinois has been a leader since the beginning of February among all of the biggest states in the nation. That's a lot to be proud of, frankly, the being better than California, better than New York, better than, you know, all of these very, you know, Florida is another example, Texas, at getting administration of doses into people's arms. That's a big deal, and especially when you have a decentralized public health system like we do here in the state of Illinois. We have 97 local public health departments. They don't answer to the Illinois Department of Public Health. They are our partners, but they answer to their county boards. And so what we try to do is work together with them to help them push vaccines out into the community, into people's arms, and they're doing it tremendously well.
Governor, I think you're gonna love this one. Election Day is like less than 20 months away. We've already got a... I ask this because there is a declared candidate on the Republican side. Kemp, who declared, former state senator, declared a couple of days ago, and already he's taken shots at you for handling of the pandemic and lumping you and Bruce Rauner, of all people, in the same pot as, you know, wealthy business executives, corporate executives who become governor and lost touch with the state. And it's never been more evident than the handling of the pandemic. How do you respond to that?
Well, the first thing I would say is I don't think I'm anything like Bruce Rauner. The second thing I'll tell you is I'm really not focused on an election that's 20 months away. What I am focused on is making sure that we get people in Illinois, the families of Illinois, protected, that we're making sure that we have an economic recovery that is second to none, and preserving, building on the job opportunities that exist for us in the state as we vaccinate everyone, get to herd immunity, and get past this pandemic. So that is my focus. There is no politics involved in that. You've heard me say from day one, I am focused on the science, on following the advice of the doctors, of the epidemiologists that know best. And one of the results of doing that is that we really have, as a major global state, you know, with a global city, with all of the possibility of turning into a state that ran out of all the resources that we would need, we didn't. We had the hospital beds, we had the ICU beds, we had the doctors and nurses to be able to care for people who were stricken with COVID-19. And so I think I'm very proud of what we've accomplished for the state. We have a ways to go. We have one more leg here to go, everybody. So like I said before, please wear your mask. Please help everybody out. Please get vaccinated. We'll get past this.
One more question.
What do you think of Mike Madigan leaving, and what do you hope happens over there with the House speakership going forward?
Well, I'm very pleased that we have a new speaker, and this speaker in particular, Chris Welch. He's a friend for some time now. He's really a great leader, and I know that he'll do a great job. And we've made history in the state of Illinois, electing the first black Speaker of the House. Look, I wish Chairman Madigan, former Rep Madigan, former Speaker Madigan, well. I mean, one thing I will say is that when you serve as long and in as dedicated a fashion in terms of just his sheer, the number of hours that the man put into the job, his family can really suffer. It's a challenge for the spouses and children and grandchildren of somebody who's put that much into public service. And I really just want to call them out today and say they really deserve kudos for, you know, the public service that former Speaker Madigan did, because it's the family that often suffers the, you know, the fact that he's not home when they would like him to be.
Family aside, his associates are accused of influence peddling almost with ComEd. I mean, is it a good day for Illinois government that we get rid of at least the appearance of a guy who's compromised?
Look, all I can say is that is running its course. You know, that's something that I feel like I have said for some time now, that that's that kind of the innuendo, the you know, the accusations that exist that are around things like that are not good. Those of us who serve in public office, who serve with integrity, you know, all of those kinds of accusations and investigations unfortunately reflect poorly on public service in general. And I really believe it's our job to tell the truth, to be honest, to do the right thing, to serve with integrity, and I continue to try to do that every single day.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
That's a wrap.
Thank you, Governor.
I'd like to get my question about labor and
get JB.
Let's take 5 seconds.